And do our council members or school board have any words you'd like to share with us today before we get started?
Just want to speak for us all.
I want to say that the importance of this school, this education, the battle that we went through to make this school for each and every one of you, the name that it carries to gain and learn, the importance of that name, and also not only that, but the importance of these leaders, these people here. There's nothing that's been given to the Puyallup tribe, nothing that we didn't have to fight for, like this school, like the HVAC system. And I just want to tell you kids, don't ever give it up. That fight that you have in each and every one of you, whether it's sports, education, or your culture, any of it, never give up on it. It's a struggle for all of us, our parents. Your ancestors before you were literally punished. They were put in boarding schools. They were taken from their families and punished for speaking the language, driving and singing. So it's a pleasure today to be at this school, you guys. Each and every one of you. You should be proud of it. Proud of this leader, this name that means so much to each and every one of us. So thank you guys. For our charities, including us leaders in this celebration. Because we're very proud to be here in one of you guys. Thank you.
Set forth for the big shoes education. want you to have those opportunities too. And that's why I talk about vocational training. It's completely important. You know, with that, I'm a warrior. Once a warrior, always a warrior. I will always be a warrior for the rest of my life. I will always represent this school, this tribe, and this community. So thank you.
Thank you. mother was invited to Yakima School. After celebrating the anniversary of the birth of Jesus, I had women coming from tomorrow. Letters from my heart, so I showed you in our dance of him and the greatest of the men who was walking in the very room. I was he still walked. Then he made his home.
Thank you. kids have stepped up and they've done amazing things. We're building this program from scratch, and we're super excited. Something to think about in the future if you want to join us, talk to counselors. But I have to introduce these amazing kids, and we have some helpers also, so we're going to have these kids introduce themselves.
Hello, everyone.
Leschi was born to be a leader. His people believed.
believed that the star rose over the stony plains on the day of his birth in 1808. Predestined him to become someday a war chief on behalf of his people. Last night his parents were his holy father and the actual mother. It was then the custom of the Tuscola people to arrange marriages outside of the tribal lineage so as to minimize the shortness in stature and the broadness of the shoulders that is typical of the Cadoux Indians of the Puget Sound. This mixed heritage provided Leschi with a tall, agile body, strong, heavy shoulders, and a face more slender than others in his village. Most distinguishing and most remembered by those who were to describe him later were his alert, penetrating eyes that seemed to size up the situation immediately. As he grew to adulthood, he became known as a man of great intelligence, possessed of superb oratorical abilities. He developed the wisdom of a judge and was often called upon to settle disagreements among his tribesmen. After Medicine Creek, Leschi would live in peace among whites for 21 years, became the primary focus of the fury and vengefulness of Isaac Stevens. Perhaps it was simply that Leschi was the first Native American to stand against him face to face, to condemn the inaugural treaties of gross inequities.
Ah,